अधिनायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्राविड उत्कल बंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्चल जलधि तरंगा तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे
guest of today's function, Honorable Governor of Goa and Chancellor of Goa University, Shri P.S. Sridharan Pillai, President of the function, Chairman, Dhempe Group of Companies and Dhempe Charities Trust, Shri Srinivas Dhempe, the Principal of DCT's Dhempe College of Arts and Science, Miramar Goa, Professor Vrinda Borkar, dignitaries in the audience, special invitees, faculty members, students, members of the press. Welcome to the inaugural ceremony of the Vasantrao Dempo Diamond Jubilee Lecture Series, where ideas converge. Odysseys are long and arduous. They entail foresight, rigorous planning, and ultimate effort. The founding fathers of this magnanimous institute that embraced all in the spirit of learning and dissemination of formal education possessed grit and pioneering facets that enabled not only the establishment of a legacy of higher education, they laid the blueprint for others to follow. 59 years, with all the trials and triumphs, have gone by, and DCT's Dhempe College of Arts and Science stands as a testimony to what has now culminated into our vision, learning, innovation, creation, inclusion, empowering society through holistic education. To mark the momentous beginning of our 60th year celebrations and the Vasantrao Dempo Diamond Jubilee Lecture Series, where ideas converge, we have amidst us the distinguished presence of the Honorable Governor of Goa and Chancellor of Goa University, Sri P.S. Sridharan Pillai. We at DCT's Dhempe College of Arts and Science are honored to have you grace this occasion and add to its stature, sir. A warm welcome to you. Also present on the dais is the Chairman, Dhempe Group of Companies and Dhempe Charities Trust, and the President of today's function, Sri Srinivas Dhempo. We welcome you, sir. Joining us on the dais is the principal of DCT's Dhempe College of Arts and Science, Professor Vrinda Borkar. Welcome, madam. We are also in the august company of dignitaries from across the state of Goa who have joined us to mark today's joyous celebration. A warm welcome to all. Today, being an auspicious day, we would like to begin with an invocation piece. I invite Ms. Veda Desai, our student who represented the state of Goa at Ek Bharat Shrestha Bharat, to present her rendition on the Ganpati and Saraswati Stuti.
Hello. Vakratunda Mahakaya Surya Koti Samaprabha Nirvignam Kurume Deva Sarvakarishu Sarvada Nirvignam Kurume Deva Sarvakarishu Sarvada Sarvakarishu Sarvada Sarvakarishu Sarvada Ya Kundindu Tushar Har Dhavala Ya Shubhra Vastavruta Ya Veena Vardanda Manditakara Ya Shweta Padmasana Ya Brahma Chuta Shankara Prabhuti Bihi Devai Sada Vandita Sama Patu Saraswati Bhagavatim Nishesha Zadya Paha Shuklam Brahma Vichar Sar Parama Adhyam Jagad Vyapinim Veena Pustaka Dharinim Abhayadham Zadyandhakati Spatika Malikam Vidhadatim Padmasanim Saustitam Vanditam Parameshwarim Bhagavatim Buddhi Pradam Sharadam Vanditam Parameshwarim Bhagavatim Buddhim Pradau Sharadam.
Professor Vrinda Borkar, to welcome this gathering. Madam.
Good evening all. Chancellor of Goa University, Shri P.S. Sridharan Pillai. Honorable Vice-Chancellor of our University, Professor Varun Sahani, Director of Higher Education, Shri Prasad Lulekar, our Chairman, Shri Srinivas Dempo, Trustee Madam Pallavi Dempo and Yatish Dempo, Administrator, Joy of Launching Diamond Jubilee Celebration of Dhempe College. The first institute of higher learning in the state of Goa, Dhempe College of Arts and Science, was established on 20th June 1962, affiliated to University of Bombay, just 6 months after Goa's liberation, sir. Goa got liberated on 19th December 1961. It was the brainchild of number of educationists, philanthropists. Prominent among them were late Vasantrao and Vaikuntrao Dempo, ex-chief minister of Goa, D.B. Bandodkar, Rector Parikh, Santu Bharani, and the first principal of Dhempe College, Dr. Y.V. Lavande. They were determined that Goans should no longer be deprived of higher learning for want of educational institutes. This thought of affordable education to all strata Sri Srinivas Dempo. Today, during the launch of this Diamond Jubilee year, I feel myself honored to You must have seen the video which we have prepared. Always aimed at holistic development, accept the global challenges. Thus, the institution is alma mater to the leaders across all the strata, green spectrum of the societal positions in Goa, India, and abroad. Alumni are directors of national organization, scientists of renowned institutes, universities, VCs, registrars, members of education committee, judges, doctors, writers, economists, artists, and also MPs, MLAs, and ministers. With its vision, learning, innovation, creation, inclusion, empowering society through holistic education, the college has carved a niche for itself as a center of excellence in teaching. Qualified, self-motivated staff, which in last 59 years upgraded infrastructure, technologies, skills and courses according to the needs of the time. New disciplines like biotechnology, computer science, psychology, MSc analytical chemistry and research center in chemistry were also added. As the socio-economic milieu underwent a transformation and posed new challenges to education, the institute offered myriad opportunities in sync with collaborations with institutes due to globalization. In the new millennium, the college started value addition skill development courses since the year 2000 and the personality enhancement programs also. In era of information technology, the college faculty incorporated blended learning and flipped classroom to the conventional chalkboard method. Thus, during the pandemic, they could seamlessly adopt the online teaching, created videos of e-content. College organized online international national symposium, conferences, webinars, quizzes, competitions, COVID awareness programs, and many more for last 1.5 years. Signing MOUs and research organizations and international universities like INSEM France, Major University Japan, organizing visits of students and staff to Japan, organizing the international conferences, online symposiums, inviting Nobel laureates, scientists from Japan, India, Nepal, Bangladesh, Europe, USA as a resource person, exposure to the staff and students. Encompassing the social responsibility, faculty are involved in extension services in select villages under Unnat Bharat, creating awareness about the societal issues, green initiatives, mental health awareness, internships at old age homes, orphanages, school for special children, conducting workshops for farmers, entrepreneurs, and school teachers, to name a few. In its constant pursuit of academic excellence and innovation in teaching, learning, and extension, the institution has achieved several landmark feats. It is accredited by NAC with A grade since 2010, awarded with College with Potential for Excellence by UGC, ranked by NRF 2020 in the band 151 to 200, Institution Innovation Council of the College is received 4-star rating on a scale of 5. India Today Survey Science Stream was ranked 87th and Arts Stream 97 among colleges in India. College is also ISO certified and green certified for practicing and promoting ecological sustenance and environmental friendly initiatives. As we enter, sir, in the 60th year, the college will have to revamp the educational system mainly because of the challenges post-COVID. There will be metamorphosis in education if new education policy is implemented in true spirit. The teachers are to be trained for developing the curriculum and change in pedagogy. Having already adopted the hybrid model of flipped classroom with chalkboard, it is easier to accept the challenges of teaching learning. Rote learning, memorizing, reproducing the same during examination without understanding the concept, without having inclination to the subject, will be replaced by recognizing the latent talent of students in cultural, sports, literature, research, love for various subjects, mold them, support them, develop their hidden talent. This talent will yield them credits, and the credits will give them a degree and develop a society of high standard and quality in all the fields. Dhempe College will definitely meet all the challenges to accomplish its vision and take lead in revolutionizing the education system by implementing transformational national education policy. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, madam. May I now call upon the president of this inaugural function, Chairman Dhempe Group of Companies and Dhempe Charities Trust, Sri Srinivas Dhempe, to place his thoughts before this audience.
Very good evening to all of you. At the outset, this hall is named after Swami Vivekananda. So I'd like to start with offering my Sashtang Pranams to this great leader, who was not only a visionary, but was living way beyond his times and saw a very strong and vibrant India to follow. Most respected chief guest of our today's function, Honorable Governor Sri P.S. Sridharan Pillai, who I had the fortune of meeting about a week back. And I must tell you that I have never seen a more humble person. We went there as a delegation of the Chamber of Commerce. Our governor, who's so well read about Goa, who's so well informed about Goa, I think he was not even a month old in Goa at that point in time, but was very, very sympathetic to the views of business, extremely informed about what's happening in Goa. And I think we are very, very blessed, sir, to have you today amongst us to deliver a keynote address on a topic which all of us are really brainstorming, trying to see how best we can implement the vision of the government, the vision of the people of India. Because the new education policy is a real welcome change. We've deliberated within our college, within the system. The Honorable Vice Chancellor is here. We've had a couple of brainstorming sessions with him. We've got Prasad Lolekar, who's our Director of Higher Education. We've met several times. This new education policy is very, very high on intent, but challenge is really the delivery. And I think that's why one of the reasons that we are celebrating 60 years, not only of the state of Goa, where we got our liberation 14 years later than our great country, but the 60 years of this institution. And what we need to understand is that the foundation set up by all the visionaries that my principal mentioned, those foundations we need to build on. And without forgetting the major objectives of setting up this institution, tread on a path which really leads you to making the students, the future kids, the future citizens of tomorrow, more employment oriented, more fulfillment as an individual. Because a lot of times, the education system that British gave us really did not focus on making us employable. And keeping with the changing times, I think somewhere down the line, we missed the road of catching it too fast. But I must congratulate the new government for having the courage who should embark on this journey in the future. My grandfather, late Vasantrao Dempo. And mind you, many of our parents, and some of you may have had to travel, had to go out at a young age to different states, where the transportation system was not very advanced. Going to Bombay took 2-3 days. And that's how students went and studied. And the entire purpose of setting up this institution is to provide. And I'm very, very happy to tell you, I consider myself extremely fortunate to be amongst the third generation of this family who have seen this institution not only exist and sustain, but also thrive and blossom. And the entire credit should go to the entire system, including our own principals, her entire team of faculty, non-teaching staff, my governing board, who has been very, very supportive, my fellow trustees, the entire ecosystem. Unless the Goa University supported us, unless the government supported us, unless the chancellor supported us, we could not have done all this, what we did. And it was your support, the blessings of Goa and Goans, that took us forward. And as principal has said, we will support her fully with meeting on the future challenges of the education sector. That means embracing more of technology. Many of you all might have heard, these days billions of dollars of deals are done on Zoom and Microsoft Teams. So while nobody can replace the campus experience, I think we must thank technology for giving us at least a medium to continue with our objective and mission of educating children and giving them access to quality education. Once again, I must thank the Honorable Governor for being so kind to accept our invitation. As I said, you know, he himself is a linguist. He's authored so many books. And if I'm not mistaken, sir, you've also been a student union leader. So he knows he's got the pulse and the feel of a campus in college. So we are very fortunate to have him. Once again, a warm welcome. And I would like to sign off by committing on behalf of the trust and the family that we will remain committed to the cause of making Goa as one of the best states in not only higher education, but that includes
that the governor of the state of Goa and the Chancellor of Goa University is with us to share in the journey. Welcome. We would like to present our chief guest with a posy. I request our student, Ms. Sakshi Lavande, to mark 6 decades in the journey of this institution, its Diamond Jubilee, a special logo that encompasses traditional symbols as well as the spirit of modernity, has been requested the chief guest, Honorable Governor of Goa, to unveil the logo. Thank you, sir. The logo has been designed by our final year student, Mr. Mandar Naik, and he will now be felicitated by the Honorable Governor for his efforts. He receives a certificate, a cash prize, and a memento for his creative design. I request the chief guest, Honorable Governor, to bestow upon him the said prizes. Mr. Mandar Naik was mentored by Assistant Professor Dr. Manjanath Naik. Thank you, sir. I now invite Dr. Akshata Bhatt to formally introduce the chief guest of this Diamond Jubilee inaugural.
Esteemed dignitaries, delegates, and student attendees joining us at the Swami Vivekananda Hall and through digital media, it is my honor to present before you a brief profile of the illustrious oeuvre of the distinguished speaker of today's inaugural lecture, Honorable Governor of Goa and Chancellor of Goa University, Sri P.S. Sridharan Pillai. Hailing from the Venmani Panchayat of Alappuzha district in Kerala, the Honorable Governor graduated in arts from Pandalam NSS College. He later pursued his degree in law from Calicut Law College, completing the course in 1978. Dear students, you may be especially inspired by the fact that as a student as well, the Honorable Governor occupied several pivotal roles. He was elected office bearer of the college union. He was the editor of the college magazine. He was elected as Law College Union Vice Chairman and also elected Senate Member of the Calicut University. These roles are testimony to his proactive contribution in vitalizing thought and discourse in society as a student as well. The sheer diversity of his roles as a nodal functionary in various fields gathers special context in the paradigm of holistic development. From being a dynamic leader, a senior central government and state president of the Kerala Publishers and Writers, owing to his literary erudition, to several significant positions in the field of sports as well. Such is the wide-ranging spectrum of his work. In 2020, Honorable Sir was bestowed with the D.Litt honor by the JJT University. In view of his achievements in governance and leadership, he was appointed the 21st Governor of Mizoram in 2019. And in July 2021, he was sworn in as the 22nd Governor of the state of Goa. His intellectual felicity seamlessly transmutes as words on the literary canvas as he writes in English and Malayalam on topics related to legal, social, and political issues. So far, he has written more than 130 books, including 15 poetry collections, as a bilingual author. The family of Honorable Governor is also significantly contributing to national development, mainly through the fields of law and medicine. Dignitaries and delegates, as our nation advances to scale newer heights in areas of academics, research, and human resource management, we are honored to have amidst us a successful lawyer, former politician, an organizer par excellence, orator, prolific writer, philanthropist, and thinker delivering the inaugural lecture in the Vasantrao Dempo lecture series on the theme Rethinking the Indian Education System. Welcome, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, Akshata.
Chairman of the function, Mr. Srinivasthi, Honorable Vice Chancellor, Honorable Principal of this college, and distinguished guests and my dear friends. I am extremely happy to attend this function, since it gives me great pleasure to be present on this occasion of the inaugural ceremony of Vasantrao Dempo Diamond Jubilee Lecture Series. There are four reasons for my happiness. It happens to be my first public appearance after assuming office of governor in Goa. Secondly, it is known to me that this is the oldest and renowned institution of state of Goa, subject to correction I am saying, because they told me like that. And thirdly, the event is taking place in the hall of Swami Vivekananda, who has been a majestic symbol of learning and reduction, and whose thoughts have reverberated throughout the world. And fourthly, it happens to bring back memories of my days as an office bearer of the college union, in my arts college, in law college, and three times from the constituency of registered graduates, had occasion to serve the university senate also of the Calicut University. And during the time of emergency, I was the Loga Sankar Samadhi Kerala state convener, and at that time I had occasion to take initiative for publishing a local magazine, and its contents in that, including its cover page, was objectionable. And that I can proudly say what I did at that time was for the existence of a democracy, a contribution in my own way. So under this background, I am extremely happy to attend this function. And regarding education, of course, before time I am starting, my scheduled time is 4:40, but now only 4:35. So 5 minutes additionally I got. And education is concerned, the experts are before me. Actually, I am expected to get more and more information from the educationist participating in this function. Of course, I am having my own views. Starting from Swami Vivekananda, that picture is there. I am very much committed to the ideology propounded by Swamiji. And I am starting with the education. Of course, change is there and other things. I will go to that, and I will express my opinion. But according to Swami Vivekananda, education is the manifestation of perfection within a person. Still, I am believing in that theory. Of course, Vice Chancellor, Registrar, and so many persons are participating in this function. Education is the manifestation of what is within, or perfection of what is within a man. This idea is still, I consider, we should follow that. And this definition given by Swamiji, of course, we are not able to go into deeply in that concept. And our great leaders also, Tagore, Gandhiji, and all other eminent personalities of our country also given similar views on education. What happened to that is a question I am not attempting to give an answer to that. Swamiji's view is that to elicit something, that elicit process. So a person is in his inner mind, what is there, through the education system, the system should try to elicit it and give it to the society. So as far as that aspect is concerned, whenever I reached here, I visited a temple, and a nearby temple, Lata Mangeshkar, the God's gift to us, her village also, somebody told me that this is the village in which she was born, and her childhood was there, and the temple is also connected to that. So Lata Mangeshkar, Amitabh Bachchan, so many people are there. But I would like to say, well, I would like to pose a question. Of course, this great God's gift to our country, or even to the world. So how many Lata Mangeshkars or Amitabh Bachchans or great patients were there in our society? But whether the society is able to search and find out them. So we are getting an opportunity is the important thing. Getting opportunity, so many good singers, so many artists. So they are not able to come to the forefront of the society, and society was not succeed in searching and finding out them and give them an opportunity. According to me, I am saying this because, subject to correction, I am saying, I read that Gandhiji's Wardha education policy long back. I tried to search in our library, in our secretary's here, for that library. Unfortunately, the complete works of Gandhiji is not available. I am sorry to say that. Then Gandhiji's Wardha education policy, through which father of our nation's concept regarding education, we are still, of course, our Vice Chancellor, they are here. Did ever we apply our mind on that? Dr. Sakir Hussain was appointed for the purpose of implementing it by our Gandhiji, but that was not in the picture. So many commissions, I am not referring to any commission, Kothari commission, so many commissions are there. But what happened to our system of education? Of course, we are in the forefront of education. We can proudly say that our students, our teachers, and the educational institutions are promoting education properly. I am not finding fault with anybody. And the basic concept of our education, as propounded by Swami Vivekananda, Gandhiji, and others, whether we strictly follow that is a question also to be considered by our educationists. Another point I want to stress is that Swamiji, elicit from a person through education process, and through that process a comprehensive approach has to be opted by education, and as a result of the same, we will get good doctors, good educationists, good lawyers, good politicians. So, regarding that aspect, one more thing we will have to give importance is touching on the point. A teacher, suppose 40 or 50 students are in front of him, one would become a good artist, one would be a good singer, or a great mathematician. So for that purpose, in the view of Swamiji, touching on the point would make a tremendous change, and that change would be helpful to the society and the individual concerned. I can say the case of our Swamiji, Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, sir, touched on the point, then Narendra became Vivekananda. Like that Gandhiji's case, we are under the impression that Gandhiji was a lawyer in South Africa, and I am not saying anything from our my fraternity, legal fraternity. Many of the lawyers are not prepared to accept. Bombay lawyers also not prepared to accept. He must be a successful lawyer, normally. But last Gandhi Jayanti day, Times of India has published a special supplement. In that supplement, it is stated that Gandhiji was the most successful lawyer in South Africa, and his annual income at that time was $15,000 per year at that time. So he was a successful lawyer. Then how he dedicated his life, a full training in his life, what actually cost? You all know, while Gandhiji was traveling in the train in first class, he was thrown away by a saipan. Saipan is an English term. Somebody in Malayalam it is using, I write in an English article, somebody told me that saipan is not, saipan is an English term. So saipan did it. That changed the entire life of Gandhiji. And thereafter, he decided to return to India, and other things are known to the enlightened audience in this meeting. So Rabindranath Tagore also having the same opinion with respect to education. Of course, he has given 3-4 versions with respect to education at the three, four different stages. But Tagore is concerned also. I don't know whether you all are aware of it. The wonderful Tagore has written national anthem for 3 countries. We are all under the impression that for India, our Jana Gana Mana is there. And Swarna Bangla opted by Bangladesh. But Sri Lanka's national anthem also is known in the name of his disciple, but actually spirit behind it and the brain behind it, in fact, it was Rabindranath Tagore. Tagore concept also regarding education, Rabindranath Tagore said, the highest education is that which does not merely give as information, but makes our lives in harmony with all existence. So he, in fact, contributed much on that subject, eliciting and making a person fully, and along with the same, he added the concept, our lives in harmony with all existence. So correlated with every atmosphere, every situation, every circumstances, not only confined to human beings alone, but to the all existence, he will have to cooperate. Such a view, such a love, such a vast view was given by. So under such circumstances, in the presence of Vice Chancellor and other educationists, I think the subject today before us, rethinking the Indian education system, is the need of the hour, and elaborate discussion is required. And for that purpose, 1 week back, our Prime Minister has declared that even in 6 most important engineering institutions in India, reputed institutions in India, the mother tongue is being used for the purpose of education. It's a revolutionary change. Of course, different opinions may be there, so I am not going to that aspect. But at the same time, what the present system is doing is the implementation of the decisions taken by our parliament, our freedom movement, and our Vivekananda, our Gandhiji, our Rabindranath Tagore. That aspects are coming to realize through the changes in the education system. Article 350A of our constitution. Originally, Article 350 alone was there. But Article 350A of the constitution is an amendment to the constitution. I think it is in 1956 or 57. That is inserted in the constitution by way of an amendment to our constitution. I can read that. Article 350A. It shall be the endeavor of every state and of every local authority. I'm underlining local authority also. Every state and of every local authority within the state to provide adequate facilities for instruction in the mother tongue at the primary stage of education to children belonging to linguistic minority group. And we must always strive to give respect to our own culture and heritage. This was passed with amendment by way of an emergent, urgent change in the system. An amendment was needed, and amendment, whether that amendment was forced, whether it came into existence, even now, our primary education, I don't know what actually is the position in Goa. From my experience in Kerala, even now it was not implemented fully. So education system as a whole is concerned, the present move by the Union of India, even in the higher education, through the media of this local language, higher education is being given, is a welcome step, and I don't know whether it is included Bengal one college, another college in Chennai, and another in some North Indian state, and not Goa is not included in that list now. Anyway, this institution is concerned, of course, a reputed institution. If taking these things are visionary concept in education that we are doing. And another fact I want to say is that presently optimism and enthusiasm is there in the educational field during the last 1 year because of the new education policy. In NEP is concerned, of course, different views are there. That is quite natural. We are living in a democracy. In a democracy, right to differ is the basis. So anybody can say that I am not agreeing with it. I am opposing it. That is a part of the democracy, and I am not finding fault with anybody on that aspect. But I would like to say that our education is concerned, education from where we start. Regarding this aspect, I would like to say that child gets the first education from his or her own family. Even breastfeeding stage onwards, child is getting education. If we go to our ancient tenets, we would see so many things are there. Even in the womb, education is slowly getting With respect to that aspect, I am not having any authoritative records with me or any supporting documents with me. So I am not insisting that. But the Bharatiya concept is that, our nation's concept is that, even from the womb, the child is getting such types of elements of education. That is in our Puranas also, there are so many stories are there. Anyway, a child gets its the first education from his or her own family, learns from his or her own environment, and gathers learning experience from the school. It is a social process which occurs only in social environment, and without it, no one can acquire experiences. Education is therefore fundamental for achieving the fullest development of every human being. So fullest development of every human being, I think Swami Vivekananda's definition to education is centered around this concept. It is critical, therefore, that the education policy is designed to achieve this objective. Periodically, it becomes imperative that we introspect our education system and design it to suit contemporary needs. India has a very rich heritage of education. The pursuit of knowledge, wisdom, truth has always been considered in Indian thoughts and philosophy as the highest human goal. India was witness to world-class institutions of ancient India, such as Takshashila, Nalanda, and Vikramshila. The production of great scholars such as Charaka, Sushruta, Aryabhatta, Chanakya, etc., bears testimony to the highest standards of ancient education system in our country. The concept of actualization belongs to the older tradition of learning. The emphasis here was not just about understanding a concept of or a skill, but actually using and applying it for a day-to-day problem-solving process. So education should be able to make a student able to achieve the stage of a day-to-day problem-solving matured human being. For that process, we will have to give focus on that. In our new education policy 2020, this aim is very well there according to me. Even when studied the adoption of philosophical concept of practical strategies or defense techniques, the emphasis was on practice them in real life. Sagacity and ethics were also bound to this concept of learning. In the words of Sri APJ Abdul Kalam, the purpose of education is to make good human beings with the skill and expertise. Dr. Abdul Kalam's view. Our modern education system has largely been influenced by the imperatives of the British colonial era. You see, about 3 years back, there was a discussion in a London university. University's name I am not remembering. There a paper was a seminar there. On both sides, but the European students were there. Then the question was, during the colonial rule of Britishers, whether what consequence in India, whether it was helpful for India or not, that was the subject discussed by them. Then one student who is a research scholar who introduced the subject. In that subject, it is stated that English education was given to India. Railway was introduced to India. So many achievements were placed before the audience. Then on the other side, the European student scholar, he replied, he put a question there. In 16,000 and 17,000. At that stage, what was the contribution of India to the world trade? Then that boy himself, the student himself, answered, the undivided India, including the present Bangladesh and Pakistan, 27% of the world trade at that time was controlled by our Bharat, our India. 27%. Then next question, in 1947, what was the contribution, what was the share of India? Then that research scholar himself answered, in 1947, 2% was the share of India to the world trade contribution sphere. Then he posed the question whether it was beneficial to India. Then he has Deccan, Muslin and other things are there, and some theories are there. I don't want to go and discuss that aspect at this stage. So a positive development, however, was India's proclamation of legal commitment towards the education of children through Right to Education Act 2009. Though this has been the era of information and communication revolution, the application to the field of education was not to the desired level. It is only in March 2020, after the breakout of COVID-19 pandemic, that IT-enabled technologies have developed to enable students to have access to online classes. Today, India stands on the verge of 75th year of independence. The celebration of this milestone as Amrita Mahotsav will begin from the 15th August this year. We are poised to bring on the soil economic and cultural changes and assuring a new India. The significance of this new India lies in the fact of a substantial percentage of our demography is in the age group of 18 to 35 years. According to me, of course, different views may be there. According to me, the new education policy is shaped in such a way by considering the prospective wealth of this country, that is, the new generation in the age group of 18 and 35 years. Youth will constitute approximately 35% of the population over the next decade, which converts into a huge resource for development. All these factors, combined with the availability of advanced technologies, opens up unimaginable opportunities for the country to transform itself into a progressive and developed country. To quote Sri Nelson Mandela, quote, "Education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world. The new education policy could not have come at a more opportune moment." This is what I want to say with respect to the new national education policy. And at the same time, in the presence of all these distinguished personalities, I would like to say one more phenomenon, because this is an arts and science college. But with respect to that aspect, recently I had occasion to read an article. In that article, it is stated that we are all heard about this Silicon Valley. We all know that is a capital of universal information technology or a software hub. We all know. A study about the most important leading five institutions in that valley, its founders or its CEOs are from their education while they evaluated, they are all degree holders or postgraduate degree holders of art subjects. None of them are connected to science or information technology. But they are the most successful patients. I can give the names also. California Silicon Valley CEO, LinkedIn's founder, Reid Hoffman. He was an art postgraduate. YouTube CEO, Susan Wojcicki. And another is Brian Chesky. Brian, we know all these companies. And Alibaba CEO, Jack Ma. All these five, they are, in fact, Silicon Valley, of course, the backbone of Silicon Valley are these institutions. Their CEOs, chief executive officers, are not from science field, not from information technology field, but they are either from the art subjects, or even one person is a postgraduate in language also. That shows the most important crux of the matter is the confidence, practical approach. Merely an education setup is contributing something, that is not sufficient. So these aspects are also to be considered. At this stage, our country is concerned. A self-reliant India is the objective to be achieved. And for that purpose, we are trying. And I would like to submit before you, we all contribute for that purpose. And education does not merely confine to literary or scientific studies. But the practical approach has to be opted. That is what I want to state before you. And this is a very good opportunity. And for giving me such an opportunity, I am thankful to you. And Goa is concerned. When I studied, per capita income in India, present stage I can't see, about 3-4 years back, this was the maximum per capita income in our country is in Goa. We all will try to regain that position. And with these few words, I'm extending my sincere thanks to all. Thank you very much. Jai Hind.
Thank you, sir. We will constantly strive for excellence and take your pointers to continue to make our institution a place where talent will always be recognized and honed. We would also continue to emulate the philosophies of our great visionaries. There are not enough ways by which our institution, DCT's Dhempe College of Arts and Science, can place on record its gratitude to the Honorable Governor for making time for our special occasion. As a token, we would like to present a memento to the Honorable Governor. We would also like to present him with a limited edition coffee table book titled Trailblazer, The Life and Times of Vasantrao Dempo, and a replica of the Diamond Jubilee logo. I request the President, Chairman Sri Srinivas Dempo, to do the honours.
of talking with respect to its founder and about Srinivas also. But due to the time, when I looked into my watch, it was 5 o'clock. That is why I omitted to mention it. On this occasion, I would like to begin by paying homage to Padma Shri Vasantrao Srinivas Inai Dhempo, who was an outstanding industrialist, philanthropist and educationist who founded the Dhempo group of companies. This lecture series is a fitting tribute to this great personality. Sri Srinivas is presently the chairman of the Dhempo group of companies, pioneered by his grandfather, late Vasantrao S. Dhempo. Guided by these inspiring principles of his grandfather, he has taken the company to new lights. He is a keen sports lover and is deeply involved in corporate social responsibility activities. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. May I now call upon the administrator, DCT Educational Institute's Sri Rajesh Bhatikar, to propose the vote of thanks.
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of all of us at Dhempe College of Arts and Science, I express our sincere gratitude to His Excellency Sri P.S. Sridharan Pillai, Honorable Governor of Goa and Chancellor of Goa University. We are indeed grateful to him for his presence amidst us today to launch the Diamond Jubilee celebrations of this college and for delivering the inaugural lecture in the Vasantrao Dempo Diamond Jubilee lecture series on the theme Reimagining the Indian Education System, a topic that holds relevance to all of us connected with education. We are also extremely grateful to Honorable Vice Chancellor of Goa University, Professor Varun Sahni, Director of Higher Education, Mr. Prasad Dholiyakar, Registrar of Goa University, Dr. Radhika Nayak, for their gracious presence today here on this occasion. I also express our grateful thanks to the trustees of Dhempo Charities Trust, members of the governing body of the college, members of the IQAC, the PTA, and the Alumni Association, heads of departments, members of the media, and all invitees who are present here in person or have joined this session in virtual mode. Finally, my sincere thanks to members of the teaching and non-teaching staff of this college who are working behind the scenes to make the Diamond Jubilee year a truly memorable one. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Please rise.
Janagana mana adhinayaka jayahe Bharata bhagya vidhata पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्राविड उत्कल गंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्चल जलधि तरंगा तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.